under total Soviet control. Miller's been captive for 10 days. Not much time left.
Weather will clear shortly.
Storm's passing.
Solo infiltration of the Soviet main ground forces. Should be the perfect warm-up. Kazuhira Miller is being held in Darwin Dehar to the north. Check its location now. Take out your eye droid. Can't have much left in him. I give him 3 days, tops. If we fail, and he dies, we lose our chance of revenge.
Center of your field of view. Sight, sound, keep all your enemy senses in mind. When you're near an enemy, stay low and move slowly. Don't leave bodies out in the open. Find some place to drop them out of sight. Planning to walk the whole wilderness on foot? Use your horse. At the enemy outpost, Violo Village. The village is crawling with enemy soldiers. Don't just go waltzing in. Start with some recon. Is there anywhere that overlooks the village? Security. If there are clues to Miller's whereabouts, I'll bet you can find them in there. Medicinal plant. Bring it back to base. It's sure to be useful sometime. It's an enemy guard post. Watch yourself. Start gathering. you've reached 1 day. Miller's being held somewhere in that town. But we don't know exactly where he is. You can keep gathering intel or make an entry into the town now.
It's me. I'm here to get you out.
Snake.
They do something to your eyes?
No, it's just bright as all. Took you so long.
We'll talk, but not here.
You've secured the target. I'll send the chopper to get you out. Make your way to the RV. You can check the location on your iDroid.
Save for all time's sake. Don't you wait.
captured it alive.
For the Seychelles. That's where our new home is now. Hey. That was some operation we had, huh? 9 years ago. Carving out our own world. Making our own future. And they took it away. Yeah, we were dogs, all right. Slinking around out of Cypher's sight. Digging up whatever kind of dirty money we could find. You name it, we did it. You see this? Diamond Docks. Our new home. The phantom of our former selves. Triumph. Death. Out either. Yeah. I remember it all.
Target is a Spetsnaz detachment commander. Your orders are to take him out. With skills like his, it'd be a shame to waste him. But I'll leave the method up to you. Boss, make your way to Dishago Calais and eliminate the target. Thank you. Roger. Is to rescue a prisoner being held at Lamar Hati Palace. He's known as Malak, Angel to his fellow Mujahideen. Start by checking the target's VI on your iDroid. The Soviets captured him and took him to the ruins of the palace. His family was subsequently killed in an airstrike on his village. The Soviets' scorched earth operation wiped it off the map. The client is none other than his father. Or rather, this was his father's dying wish. If you can manage to rescue other prisoners as well, each one will add a bonus to our pay. When you see them, I'm sure your conscience will tell you what to do. Thank you. subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Granada!
Roger.
Momentum.
Snake! Call the chopper from your iDroid, boss. Then carry the target to it. Boss, you're just leaving the target.
Прием! Отдыхай, понял. Заведи Нипсон. Будьте бдительны и найдите нарушителей.
Roger. Disable the Soviets' reinforcement system by putting a hole in their base-to-base comms network. Head for the Eastern Communications Post and destroy its comms equipment. First, use the binoculars to locate the communications equipment at the facility. Thank you. munitions equipment at the facility. Get out of the hot zone.
Thank you.
Captured it alive. military's new weapon codenamed Honeybee. The CIA put it in the hands of the Hamid group of Mujahideen. But the Hamid fighters were wiped out. The Honeybee must still be hidden at their base, the fort at Dasmasi Laman. Unfortunately, the Soviets are looking for the weapon as well. You have to get to it before they do, and bring it back here. There's a photo of the target on your iDroid. One more thing. Apparently, one of the Hamid fighters survived. He's missing, but if you can find him, he might lead us to the target. Good luck, boss. Soviet relay base. I think there's something in there that could lead us to the Honeybee. Boss, get down.
Конец связи. окажется поблизости. Соблюдайте осторожность.
You're pretty good.
Что?
Стоп! Это кафе! Ответьте! Стоп! Ответьте! Стоп! Стоп!
Thank you.
Smasse Fort to Smasse Lamont. Now to find the honeybee.
Attacked the Soviets too.
And that Grim Reaper lookalike in charge of them.
That giant thing that carried him off. What the hell are they?
Cypher.
What do they want? What's their objective? Why Afghanistan? There's one more thing troubling me.
What happened to the Hamid?
Exactly. Whole squads of hardened Mujahideen killed without a fight, and no trace of BC weaponry. What does it all mean?
That's what we're here to find out.
Yeah, right. If we really need to know, the truth will reveal itself. Even if it's ugly.
Good. He captured it alive.
Hospitalized in Dhekelia, a British sovereign base area on Cyprus. It's part of British overseas territory that falls outside of Cypriot jurisdiction. You got moved from Cuba's Little America right into Cyprus's Little Britain.
Why Dhekelia?
The UK and the US remain close allies. The last place Cypher would think to look for you is inside their own system. That's what kept you safe in British military hospital for 9 years. The safest place from a whale is inside its own belly. You were a regular Geppetto.
Well, it wasn't Pinocchio who led me out to safety. So who was that guy?
Cypher went so far as to attack British territory, burning their own ally. That's how badly they wanted you dead.
He said I was in a British military hospital. But the doctor had a Greek accent.
They hire locally. Easier to trust them. Dhekelia is also home to Greek Cypriots, after all.
What about the Turks? They haven't returned to the south.
Not yet. The Cyprus dispute is still a long way from resolved. The country is just as split as it was in 74. Turkish Cypriots in the north, Greek Cypriots in the south. Between them, the Green Line, the UN established.
And Dhekelia sits right on top of it.
It does. Part of the buffer zone between the two groups. Another reason it was the perfect place to hide you. Easy to spot any outsiders snooping around.
So how do things stand?
Last year, the Turks declared that the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus is an independent state, though it's only Turkey that recognizes it. In the past, the Greeks and Turks lived side by side in the same villages. There are reasons to fight. Those came from the outside. Greece, Turkey, Britain, America. They all have their own stake in pitting the two sides against each other. But once you spark something like this, it's impossible to control. Both sides build up grudges like debt. Without the foresight to see that each act of revenge just fans the flames. And then it's too late for other nations to rush in with peace talks. The embers keep on smoldering. Each nation's arrogance only breeds anarchy. The world is paralyzed by this hunger for revenge. Cyprus is no different.
Changing ships?
We can't go sailing the Suez in a whaler.
The Suez Canal. When did they reopen it?
Not long after you were attacked. Once they finished sweeping it for mines after the Arab-Israeli conflict. Can you stand? We're gonna transfer to a container ship for passage through the Suez. Our destination is Pakistan, Afghanistan's neighbor to the south. There we disembark and head via Peshawar to the zero line, the border. We'll travel to the Khyber Pass by road.
And then?
We continue on horseback. Afghanistan's main roads are under Soviet control. We'll need to go around them. It'll be all narrow, winding paths through the mountains. We'll do better on horseback. It's a local guerrilla tactic. They use the higher ridges to avoid air recons. Then they charge down the mountains for ambushes. the Soviets still haven't devised a counter-strategy. Our time frame is only half as much as we really need. It's gonna be a tough march.
Better horses than boats.
Well, it'll make for good physiotherapy. Take the time to get used to that new arm.
While the Soviets have indicated they are not participating in the Los Angeles Olympics, primarily because the United States has made no attempt to guarantee the safety of the Soviet Union's athletes, the United States is increasingly demonstrating the belief that the issue has nothing to do with its preparations, and in fact this is retaliation for the Western nation's boycott of the previous Moscow Olympics. That concludes today's news.
That's quite some news.
The Soviet Union not attending the LA Olympics? Yeah. Andropov's death has changed some things. They're calling it revenge for the Western boycott of the Moscow Olympics.
Countries boycotted the Moscow Olympics?
Yes. In protest of the Soviet Union's invasion of Afghanistan, over 50 countries were absent. It's too bad I didn't get to see Yamashita's judo. When the 40th Army crossed the Amu River 4 years ago, detente went right out the window. The U.S. Congress chose not to ratify SALT II. And Reagan's hardline politics won him the presidency in a landslide. According to him, the Soviet Union's an evil empire.
A second Cold War.
And there's been no end to regional conflicts and civil wars. Lebanon, the Falklands, Grenada, Iran, Iraq. The story never changes.
Egypt and Israel did sign a peace treaty. But then the driving force on the Egyptian side, President Sadat, was assassinated afterward. Apparently, his actions were considered a betrayal of his fellow Arabs.
Islamic extremists?
Yes. Fundamentalist extremists have been responsible for some bold acts of terrorism in recent years.
We've had extremist students in Iran take U.S. embassy workers hostage, and suicide bombings in Lebanon. Over 300 foreign soldiers stationed there have been killed.
Countries have yet to develop an effective means of dealing with terrorism. Afraid of losing their own men, they've pulled their forces out, handing private forces a golden opportunity.
Private forces?
Small armies with no national affiliation, working for the highest bidder. That's right, they got the idea from you. After Mother Base went down, they began spreading to meet the soaring demand. Miller's organization is just one of many PFs now. The entire world is after you. But at the same time, it needs you too. Miller told me about what happened in the Caribbean 9 years ago. You do remember Miller. You'd formed a private army with him. An army with no allegiance to a nation.
I remember, but...
I see. You're not sure what's fact and what's a fantasy caused by the coma.